Hello everyone, what's up? I hope all is well. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a portfolio website using Cursor AI. So this is their website, Cursor AI. If you're not familiar with what Cursor AI is, let me break it down for you. It's essentially a code editor that comes with built-in AI technology. This means you can use their chat feature, which you can see right here, to interact with the AI. With this chat feature, you can give commands and ask the AI to help you create whatever you need. For example, you can tell it to generate code or even build entire sections of a website. Using Cursor AI, you can develop any type of website you want. It's really versatile. So they offer a free version that you can download. Once you've downloaded it, you'll need to sign up for an account. After signing up, you'll get access to a limited but functional free version, which is perfect for creating websites. To get started, just head over to cursor.com and download the editor. Once it's downloaded, make sure you sign up for an account. After signing up, open up Cursor AI and you'll be greeted by their platform. This is where the magic happens. It's their code editor. Now, I know this part might feel a little confusing, but don't worry, I'll guide you through it. First, make sure you click on this toggle window here and then click on the chat feature. This is their AI-powered chat system, and it's what we'll use to build our project. Also, before we dive in, we'll need to create a new folder for our project. This will help keep everything organized as we work. So, I'll name this project Portfolio Website, and then select the folder. Now we have a new folder to work with. Next, we need to go back to the toggle window here and click on Chat. Now, I'll type in my request. I'd like to create a portfolio website. I'm a web designer. My name is Sunny, and I'm based in London. Then, I'll add some more details. I want a one-page website with different sections. Make sure the website is responsive and the menu is easy to navigate. Use classic blue colors and ensure everything is perfectly aligned. Once I've entered that, I'll hit enter, and now Cursor AI will do its magic. As you can see, it's generating all the code for use. It's clean, fast, and efficient. By the way, this is the free version, but if you want even more features, you can upgrade to the premium plan. I'll show you their packages later. Now that the code generation is done, what we need to do next is create all the necessary files. Don't worry, Cursor AI makes this process incredibly easy. If we go back to the main view, you'll see that this is our index.html file, the main file for our website. To generate it, I'll click on Apply. As you can see, the file and code have been created. To finalize the changes, I just need to click on Accept. Done. The file is now ready. Next, let's create our CSS file. I'll scroll down, click on Apply, and make sure to select Style, CSS. Once it's applied, I'll click on Accept, and now we have our Style, CSS file ready to go. Now if I scroll down even further, you'll notice this is the script file. I'll click on Apply, and the script has been applied. Great. Now, what I want to do is go back to the project folder and open it up to see what we've created so far. Here's the project folder, and when I open it, you can see the website starting to take shape. For example, here's the intro. Hello, I'm Sunny, a web designer based in London. If I scroll down to the About Me section, you'll notice that while the layout is functional, the images aren't loading properly yet. Let's also check the responsiveness. Ah yes, the responsive menu works fine. That's a good start. Now I'll head back to Cursor AI to make some improvements. I'll type in, for images, please use placeholder images from pixel.com. Make the website more elegant by adding animations and enriching the content in all sections. Once I hit enter, Cursor AI will generate additional code to implement these changes. Now, here's an important step. You need to apply the new code to the corresponding files. Don't worry, it's automatic for the most part. You just need to confirm the changes by clicking apply and then accept for each file. Let's see what's happening now. The AI is generating the updated CSS code, and it's also working on the script.js file. Once that's done, I'll go back to review the changes. Starting with the existing code up to the About section, I'll click Apply, confirm the changes by clicking Accept, and move on. Next, I'll handle the CSS updates, click Apply, then Accept. Finally, I'll do the same for the script.js file. It's that simple. Now let's preview the website again to see how it looks. It seems to be loading a bit slowly, but here we go. Okay, the images still aren't working, but wow, the overall design is starting to look much better. The hero section is clean, and we're definitely getting somewhere. However, there's still room for improvement. I'll go back to Cursor AI and add more instructions. Okay, now it's working on the CSS updates. Great. With that done, I'll go back up to the index content section. Click apply and then confirm by clicking accept. I think I might have applied the wrong change earlier. Oops, no worries though. Let me double check and fix that. Alright, I'm back on track now. I'll go ahead and apply the correct changes for the remaining sections. Click apply, then accept. Okay, this part is done. Now, let's check if there's any JavaScript to handle. It seems like there isn't much JavaScript needed here, so I'll move forward. Let me refresh the website and see how it looks now. Good news. The images are working. Well, almost. The image in the About section still isn't loading properly. Also, I noticed the Google Map isn't showing up yet. Let's fix that. I'll head back to Cursor AI and add more instructions. Now the AI is generating the necessary code. I just need to make sure I apply the correct changes to the right files. Let's go step by step. Scroll back up to the index content. Click apply and then accept. Next, handle the CSS updates. Click apply, then accept. Finally, review any remaining changes and confirm them. Alright, everything should be applied now. Let me refresh the website again and see the results. The Google Map still isn't working, but wow, the footer looks fantastic. It's packed with so much useful information now, and yes, the About section image is finally working. Let's test the responsiveness. It's looking good. There's even a nice hover effect on the buttons. However, I do notice one small issue. The text in some areas isn't displaying correctly. But honestly, that's okay because the main point I want to make is this. This is how you can build a website using Cursor AI. Sure, there are a few minor issues, like this button not working perfectly, but with the help of the AI chat system, you can easily fix all these problems. In about half an hour to an hour, you can create a really solid portfolio website. Not bad, right? If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel. If you'd like to see more videos like this, with practical tips and useful tutorials, hit that subscribe button. I'll be back soon with more content to help you learn and grow. That's it for today's video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.